Antony committed suicide, and Octavian thus declared the civil war, Romans against Romans, to be over. On January 16th, 27 before Christ, the Senate gave Octavian the honorary name Augustus, the Exalted. The act of state marked the beginning of a new era in Roman history. Formally, the restoration of the Republic was celebrated. De facto, Augustus had created a monarchical system, with himself as princeps at the head. Neither a Republican general before nor an emperor after Augustus had incorporated larger territories into the Roman Empire. City names such as Augsburg in Germany, Saragossa in Spain, Aosta in Italy, Autun in France, and Kaiseraugst in Switzerland bear witness to the extent of his power to this day. Only his Germanic wars ended in disaster. Augustus had entrusted the experienced Publius Quinctilius Varus with his task. After his devastating defeat in the Teutoburg Forest against Arminius, Augustus is said to have proclaimed, Quinctili Vare, legiones rede. Quinctilius Varus, give back the legions, according to Suetonius. But that is another story and will be told another time. In the year before his death, Augustus publicly designated his adopted son, Tiberius, as his successor. In the summer of the year 14, Augustus fell ill and was taken to Nola, to the same house where his father had died 71 years earlier. According to Suetonius, the first Roman emperor took his leave there on August 19th, the date on which he had assumed his first consulship 50 years earlier, with words that comedians usually spoke at the end of a play. If the whole thing has pleased you, now applaud our play and dismiss us all with thanks. At the time of his death, his full title was Imperator Caesar, son of the deified, the exalted, supreme high priest, 13 times consul, 21 times emperor, 37 times holder of tribunician power, father of the fatherland. Augustus had brought Rome a long period of internal peace, stability, security, and prosperity. His reign was highly stylized as the Pax Augusta. Rome had changed, as Augustus himself said, from a city of bricks to a city of marble. Augustus founded the Roman Empire. His dynasty included the emperors Tiberius, Caligula, Claudius, and Nero. His name is still on everyone's lips. In 8 before Christ, the month of Sextilis was renamed Augustus. We still call it August today. Well, so much for Emperor Augustus, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.